This video will describe methods to calculate the above ground, below ground and total biomass of a tree or forest and how to convert biomass to carbon and carbon dioxide equivalents. However, for formal carbon accounting purposes, ensure you seek expert advice and follow all relevant legislation and guidelines, which may differ to the methods described here. Above ground biomass, or AGB, is a measure of the dry weight of a tree, including the stem, bark, branches, leaves, buds, flowers, cones and capsules. Dry weight is the weight of the tree components dried in an oven to remove their water content until the weight no longer changes with continued drying. For most tree species, the AGB is related to the DBH, so foresters have developed various equations to estimate these values. This example of an equation for AGB gives the dry weight of a spotted gum. There are many other equations that have been developed for various species in various locations. And these equations are more general in nature. They give an AGB value for hardwood trees from the eucalyptus, corymbia, and angophora genera. Conifers from the pinus, araucaria, and agathis genera that typically have relatively low stem wood density, and other tree species that typically have relatively high wood density. They are valid for plantations and natural forests throughout Australia for the DBH values displayed. It is important to note that they are less accurate for individual trees, but when predictions are made across a wide range of data, such as a whole forest, individual errors are largely cancelled out. Below ground biomass, or BGB, is a measure of the dry weight of the large and fine roots of trees. BGB can be calculated by species-specific equations, which, as before, have been developed for particular species and locations. These are most accurate to use if available. This example of an equation for BGB gives the dry weight of spotted gum roots from plantations in southeast Queensland. There are many other equations that have been developed for various species in various locations, and these should be used if available. Otherwise, a general root-shoot ratio can be applied to the AGB of a forest to estimate the BGB. These general ratios should only be used across a number of trees, such as a stratum or a forest, as they may not provide a very accurate estimate for individual trees. Total biomass is the sum of the AGB and the BGB, or the mass of all living parts of a tree or forest. For an individual tree, once you have calculated the AGB and BGB values, they can be added together to give the total biomass in kilos. For an entire forest or stratum, biomass is often expressed in tonnes of dry matter per hectare. So to calculate this figure, add the total biomass of all the trees in all plots in kilos, then divide by the total plot area and by 1,000 to convert from kilos to tonnes. The total forest biomass can also be expressed in tonnes. Calculating the carbon sequestered by a forest is an increasingly common reason to measure trees and forests. With the value of total forest biomass that you have calculated, it is an easy process to estimate both the carbon content and CO2 equivalent of your forest. Total forest biomass is converted to carbon by applying a carbon factor, which estimates the proportion of dry biomass that is carbon. Generally speaking, biomass is made up of around 50% carbon, so the carbon factor typically used is 0.5. Greenhouse gas emissions are commonly reported as carbon dioxide equivalents. This measure allows a comparison of the impact of various greenhouse gases, such as methane or nitrous oxides, in relation to their degree of atmospheric warming potential. To convert total stand carbon to carbon dioxide equivalents, multiply by 3.67, which is the ratio of the weight of a molecule of carbon dioxide to the weight of an atom of carbon.